I did not have a home anymore. I was in the street, you know? So I had to keep my reputation in the street. We didn't know what was leading to, you know?
Jamy committed a very serious offense. He kidnapped a person.
A terrible thing that I've done in this place. Why did I do it? I'm just not proud of myself.
Working with Jamy, it wasn't easy at all. A lot of our young people are going through some unresolved trauma, and they encourage each other to do negative things.
It's the moment violence erupted in the heart of Melbourne as two rival gangs clashed.
Terrifying carjackings, muggings and robberies.
A growing trend of out-of-control South Sudanese youth.
It came from being a gangster out in the streets, just trying to get respect from people. But he decided that he'd take it to the court instead and get well respected from the right people.
My name is Jamy Alex. I'm from South Sudan. I came here as a refugee. The feeling of freedom, that's when you come there, you're like, you feel it. You know, everything's open. So I really loved it. I didn't want to leave.
Jamy is my partner, the father of our two beautiful kids. When I first met him, I was 15, he was 17. We were just young and adapting into a different country, and it was a little bit hard.
We went to high school. Everything was going all right, but then one friend called me like the N-word, and I did not like that. So we got into a fight. Both of us got suspended from school.
Being hated for the color of your skin, it grew a lot of anger inside of us. So kind of makes you rebel a little bit.
My parents did not. They did not like that. So our relationship started to break down from there.
Jamy and I ended up being homeless together. Marijuana and alcohol, we both actually fell into that. Those times were terrible. He ended up stealing just to eat because money was hard to get. I think it was just the hunger really that made him do that.
I started following all these friends who go shoplifting. As we're getting older, became into more, what can I say? Robbing. You feel it like you're growing into something that's benefiting you. Like more people respecting you, and the street became the family. You have to do things out of the necessary to maintain your image. This is where the incident happened. So we came down to the plaza here. My friend decided he wanted to rob somebody. He got out of the car. He punched the guy fell down. He's like, oh, shut up, let's put him in his car. We scared the guy, put him in his car. Drove around with him, we're like, you got money? He doesn't have money. Drove around with him to the ATM, which is just around the corner there. And there wasn't much that he had. So we actually put him in his car. My friend tied him and we just left him there after. Just the pressure. I'd never felt comfortable doing it. Didn't want to be like a wimp. Like, you know, just scared and stuff like that. So I just followed. I'm like, all right, let's do it. What I felt after, I felt bad for what happened. No person deserved that, you know? So.
To be honest with you, I was shocked when he told me, but I didn't show to him that I was shocked. I provided some hope. My name is Selva Luca, and I'm the founder of Afro-Oz Care. We help mainly the youth at risk. James was one of the difficult kids to deal with. It requires patience to work with people like Jamy.
Hello, Selva. Hey, how are you?
I don't listen to much people, to be honest, you know? from when she came into my life and telling me stuff, slow, slow, I should listen to her.
If you provide opportunity, love, hope, a person can change. But where we lose young people, it's when you judge them. He cannot get better.
And you remember what I told you? The power of what?
Patience.
And?
Humble.
Forgiveness.
As girls go through, it's getting over. A bit.
The power of forgiveness.
Yeah, she became like my mother. That's Elba.
Jamy was lucky to escape from the jail sentence simply because there were people who came up to the judge saying his boy is good, he's intelligent. And because of that, Jamy did not go to jail.
I found I was so close to being in prison. It was a wake-up call to change my life.
And he said, you know what, in the community there are a lot of people like me that will benefit if you can help them. But I thought there must be an activity where they can actually express their energy. So coming from Malawi, I thought of football. But Jamy said, Mama, no, we need to have basketball.
Well, what's go for your goal in the streets? Like go rob somebody, get some more money or something like that. So when you transform that, then you go for your goal in basketball, then you defend yourself in basketball, you can. You feel good, but in the street, you get locked up, you get hurt, you can get stabbed, you can die. There's no point for that. Why not take that, transform it to the court and have fun?
Not bad, let's go. 1, 2, 3, beautiful. You can use 2 hands up there if you want.
And black rhino actually represented from Africa, you know how the rhinos is getting like extinct? Instead of dying, we'll multiply.
Let's go.
It's really beneficial for us to have some place to go and use our talents and expend some energy instead of getting into trouble, pretty much.
Instead of stealing and doing crimes, you can just have fun playing instead of doing bad stuff.
1, 2, 3. Yep, nice.
Founding the Black Rhinos has changed him to be a leader. Most of the young people are coming to the Black Rhinos because of Jamy.
We're all proud of him, and hopefully he's proud of himself too.
The founder of the Black Rhinos, Jamy Alex, come forward. And this is the little Jamy Alex.
Now I know our kids, they're gonna have a good role model. He saw himself, he wanted to be better, but he just didn't want to do it by himself. He wants to help others as well. That's a great transformation. Wow. I keep telling Selva, please just bench me. I don't know, I can't believe it.
I do especially for my kids, first of all, and my community and the family around me. I want them to understand that even though you went through all this illness, it's not too late. You know, you can turn things around. I'm the living proof.